Suddenly the dungeon looks very different. That's because I'm on the lower level. Now, while the upper level of the volcano dungeon, that is Sword and Shield Maze, has a pit that I fell, maybe ice-themed. In fact, the lower level is fire-themed, so it's basically a dual-type dungeon, like Hailfire Peaks from Banjo-Tooie. Yeah. One half the dungeon is ice, the other half is fire. So that's why there's why you find an ice level inside a volcano. It's only half the level that's ice. Oh crap. Floor master. Or wall master. I think it's floor. Okay. Floor masters are different from wall masters in that they fall down on you from above, of course, as you can see, and there's an infinite number of them. You kill one, kill one, then pretty soon another one will show up. Yep, that's a dangerous. Ah! Didn't just even stand close to it. Ah! Oh, I do not like that dude. And it kills him. Oh, that was close. And there's Potaboos. Living fireball enemies. And yet another enemy from the Mario series. Oh, I suppose in the Mario series, they don't actually have faces. Although, I'm pretty sure they're still alive! Where'd that heart go? I have no idea if that key's dropped anything for me at all. Yeah, as you can see, this is definitely not the easiest dungeon there is. This is definitely lives up to being the last of the game's 8 dungeons. Not counting the pseudo dungeon or the final boss dungeon, of course, which really aren't full. Really aren't full dungeons. Fire keys. They're like keys but on fire. And if they land on you, you get set on fire, and they lose their fire ability. Also, another difference between regular keys and fire keys is that fire keys fly up in the air, and you can't hit them when they're in the air. Unless you use your rock's cape, I believe. Yeah, you can use your rock's cape to get up to them, though. Bah! And when you get near a fire keys, it dives for you. Also, although whenever it becomes a regular keys, the fire keys continues to fly around like a fire keys, staying in the air and diving after you. This is an awful place. A room filled with ice and spikes on the ground and spike enemies which bounce you around? No, thank you. You don't actually have to go through this room, you just go through to get the compass. It can also sort of, and also now you can sort of see why it's called Sword and Shield Maze. There's the button. Oof. Should have found the steadfast ring. I think that's a real ring. It stops you from slipping. I think. I can't remember what it does. I'm just working from memory here. And another spinner puzzle. I think I need to go back around. I don't think there's anything I can do here. down here. Into a staircase. Except not that there's any... Yeah, okay. I knew it. God, my health! Oh yeah, the staircase leads up to the ice level. Except, it's on... Except, yeah, that's interesting. The ice level with lava. If I remember correctly, the puzzle in this room is that I need... Oh, okay. I think there was an owl statue in here. I somehow solved the puzzle, and I don't even know how I did it. A silent watch may be needed. Okay, that's strange. I'm pretty sure you're supposed to kill all the enemies, and then... You can awaken the Armos statue, but apparently you can awaken it. Maybe just a glitch that I awakened it without killing enemies. I'm gonna go down these stairs. Go over to through these stairs before I move forward. And just as I thought, they lead to the other end of this room. The dungeon map. Now you can definitely see that it's called Sword and Shield Maze for a reason. Look at all those rooms too. This is gonna be tricky. In fact, I don't think I can completely solve this now. Yeah. I think I need to actually get into that room through those stairs in order to solve the puzzle. There are jinxes in the dungeon. I forgot about those things. Oh, now the statue's moved. Maybe the statue only comes to life if you attack it, move up to it when there's enemies in the room, and if you... if you try to do anything with it when the enemies are gone, you can just move it like a normal statue? I have no idea. There. Oh! Nah. They don't go flying backwards when you hit them like most of these. Oh my god! And luckily, wisps can't hurt you. Useless enemies when they're alone. There, now I can use my magnetic gloves to... Or not. Okay, I have no idea how I'm supposed to move that thing. Oh. Or these red Armos Knights. The blue variety of the Armos statues are very rare, I've noticed. I haven't seen any blue Armos since... The Hyper Slingshot! No, and by the way, I'm not saying that I haven't seen any blue Armos since the Hyper Slingshot. Yeah, so basically the way the Hyper Slingshot works is a better version of the slingshot that shoots 3 seeds at a time instead of 1, while only using up 1 of your seeds. So it's incredibly useful. Now I just gotta see if there's some way I can make it useful for me to hear. Gotta be something I can do here. I know. Can't believe I didn't think of this sooner. And now I know why I need to be doing this too. I wasn't sure earlier.